little boy growing up in Chicago, I knew that there was a hero for Jewish people like myself. Yeah. There was a man that everybody liked and everybody respected, but also, curiously, he was sad. There were photographs of this man who was apparently a great genius. I had no idea what he'd invented, but he had a particularly sad face. It was a little bit like the wisdom of Nelson Mandela later, or the wisdom of Martin Luther King. And it felt like he had seen something which the rest of us hadn't, Moses, if you believe in that sort of thing. Mm-hmm. And instead of like going off and like living the life of luxury and having his private jets or whatever, he'd come back to Earth to share it. So I felt, here's a really wise man, a representative of my people. And he had seen something which meant a lot to him, but somehow troubled him. As a little boy, I had no idea what that was, and I wanted to find out what it was.
Right, fascinating. What was that?
This was all his science, the theory of relativity and things like that, which I was lucky enough to learn about at university. Mm. And I found that some of my professors, when I got to know them, they'd had the same urge themselves. When they were little, they'd had, isn't so much like looking for a dream of perfection, but they'd wanted to know what was beyond what was known, and who were those people who had gone out there and found it? Who are those people who'd gone out there and found it? You know, in the Olympics sometimes, there'll be a sport you normally don't follow. I never follow sprinting. But in Olympics, I'll watch Mr. Bolt, and I want to see, so is this what the fastest human being on Earth is like? What does he eat for breakfast? How does he run? And how does he do it?
Yeah. What were some of the key personality traits of Einstein? Was he laid back, super highly strung, workaholic, alcoholic?
Yeah. He was really good for two reasons. One is that he studied hard, and he had a terrific persistence. He used to say that I might not be smarter than other people, but I have the persistence of a mule. That was one thing. The other thing that made Einstein good was a whimsical way of stepping back from what everybody else was focused on. Do you know someone like Warren Buffett will often be a counter-cyclical investor? Not counter-cyclical in the sense of doing stocks that go up and down against each other, but doing something which nobody takes into account, something that everybody takes for granted. He'll look under it and say, I wonder about it. When Einstein was a little boy, he got upset when he was 7 years old, and he threw a bowling ball at his sister, his little sister. It hit her in the head. She wrote about it later, and she said, and this shows it takes a thick skull to be the sister of a world-famous physicist. I love that sense of humor in their family. It's like something happens, and instead of just focusing on that thing, you step back. Well, fast forward 20 years, Einstein's at university. Everybody's telling him the world works like this. Victorian science is what's true. And he has that whimsical sense of humor from his family. He's willing to say, maybe, but maybe not.
Yeah, and a great sense of humor is also linked to great intelligence, isn't it? Let's just take E equals MC squared. All of our viewers are very, very smart and well-versed individuals. But for a few people out there, what would you say, could you just give us a quick definition, I'm sure you've been asked this millions of times, of E equals MC squared? Why is it so flipping important?
Sure. The C squared is what throws people. E stands for energy, M stands for mass. We kind of know what energy is. Energy is like an explosion or something. Mass is like a solid rock or that small thing inside Donald Trump's skull. You know, so we know what mass is. We know what energy is. What's the C squared? C squared is just a very large number. It's a conversion factor. Between Fahrenheit and centigrade, you have a conversion factor. Between pounds, sterling, and US dollars, you have a conversion factor. Just a conversion factor. It says if you have a bit of one of these things, it can turn into the other, and by how much? And it turns out C squared is a number. It's a really big number. Trillions and trillions and trillions in ordinary units. So what it means is if you take a tiny little bit of mass, say a single piece of paper, and that mass, when you turn into energy, what's the conversion factor? Little bit of paper, little bit of mass doesn't become a little bit of energy. Doesn't even become a lot of energy. It becomes an incredible amount of energy. A single piece of paper, if it turned entirely into energy, multiplied by that huge number, the mass multiplied by that number becomes the energy, would be enough to destroy London and just leave a cavernous hole in the surface of the Earth where London had been. Isn't that amazing?
Yeah, absolutely. In fact, you say in your book, without E equals MC squared, without the equation, for instance, there would be no atomic bomb, no lasers, no internet, and no science of black holes. Do you think 40 years on from 1905, when the US used the atomic bomb, obviously Einstein was still alive at that point, do you think he thought, if I could undo this equation, I would have done?
You're exactly right. Einstein wasn't allowed to work on the atomic bomb project. He'd been a bit of a pacifist when he was younger, but with the rise of Hitler, he thought pacifism is not a good idea. Mm-hmm. And he would have worked on the atomic bomb project in America, but he wasn't allowed by the FBI. They thought he was a security risk, even though that wasn't true. So he thought that something was going on. He didn't know the details. In 1945, Einstein, when the atomic bomb was dropped on Japan, he was resting on his holiday home on Long Island in New York. in New York State. His secretary woke him and said, I heard this terrible thing on the news. The atomic bomb has been used. And he looked at her name was Helen Dukas, and he said, if I had known, I wouldn't have lifted a finger.